Don't forget to share the love by subscribing to my channel and contribute with a comment too.
Welcome to today's yoga class. I named it Happy Hamstrings. So we're working hamstrings today, stretching, working on balance, stability, strength, but also relaxation, of course. And we use hamstrings all the time, for example, when you're walking or squatting. And if you're a runner, a lot of times you have tight hamstrings. And also, besides running, sitting a lot can also create tight hamstrings. So let's get started. Have fun as always, do what you can and really try to tune in to your own body, what you need. If something doesn't work that I'm saying, just adjust, or you can skip the pose too. So if you have blocks, choose two of them, and also a strap or a belt, or you can be creative, you can use something else. For example, you can use, if you have big books or stack maybe. I mean, I know it's a little harder to work with books, but even pillars or something. Started seated, cross-legged as always. You want that forward tilt with your hips, so you may want to sit on a blanket or something. Roll your shoulders up and back and close your eyes if it's comfortable for you. Inhale, exhale through your mouth. One more time. And close your eyes. And just notice where you feel your breath, where it's strongest. Is it the chest, your belly? And wherever it is, just focus on this point. Just natural breathing, not forcing it. And when thoughts arise, just let them drift away like clouds, and then you get back to your breath. Start to deepening and lengthening your breath, belly, start from the belly. So inhale, belly rises, and let the air come all the way up through your rib cage, your chest, and exhale, actively draw your navel into spine and let the air out the same way. So inhale, belly rises, and exhale, belly in. You could even add an ujjayi breath here, restricting the back of your throat and sound like the ocean. A lot of research done on that breath. It's very calming and soothing. Two more breaths like this. And then normal breath. And you want to set an intention for your practice, please do so now. Slowly open your eyes, right fingers to the floor, and aligned with the hips, left arm up, and lean over to the right, and go to the other side, sitting bones on the floor the whole time. Let's do this one more time. Next time you're leaning over to the right side, just stay here, create some space. the left side of your rib cage, your waist. And the other side. And come up, spinal twist, right side, looking back. Elongate your spine with each inhale. Maybe get deeper in to the twist with each exhale. Inhale and exhale, other side, same thing. So your left hand is close to your body, so you're sitting tall. And look forward. Interlace your hands behind your back, shoulder blades together. And even move your hands from side to side. Anything that feels good. Hands on your knees. Inhale, exhale, round your spine. Inhale, arch, look up. Just kind of cat cow here, seated. Last inhale and exhale here. Coming to all. Actually, we're coming, laying down, and bring your strap or your belt. So take your strap under your right foot, under the ball of the foot here, and then you can have your left knee bent. Just gently press or pull down here with your right hand, and then straighten gently. Just move back and forth, still warming up. And then bend the knee and hold it here. So the knee is a little bit out to the right side, kind of like a happy baby with one leg. So if you can, the knee and your ankle are aligned. And then straighten your right leg, flex the foot, and center the leg. And then gently see if you can get your toes a little closer to your head. So you should feel a good stretch in the whole back of your right leg here. Take your right foot out to the right side and open the left knee to the left. So you're kind of balancing here. Come to the middle again, bend your right knee and place your right foot on the floor. So your knees come over to the left side. And your head can turn to the right side. You just look up. And back to the middle. Let's switch. So the belt or strap under your left foot. Gently bending your knees, straighten your leg. And bend the knee, hold it here, half happy baby. The whole time, smooth, steady breath. And straighten your leg and guide it to the middle. And toes closer to your head again. Get that nice stretch. The backside of your left leg. So tight hamstrings can many times lead to a lower back pain. So it's really good to be open in that area. And then open the left foot out to the side and the right knee out to the right side. And come to the middle, let go of the strap. Left foot on the floor, maybe look over to the left. We will create more range of motion in this area today. And hopefully create less injuries. So if you're open in the hamstrings, it's kind of like a rubber band. If it's flexible, it's not going to break as easily. And come to the middle, both feet to the floor. Hip width apart, heels in towards your buttocks, palms to the floor. Inhale, hips press up, and exhale down. Just a gentle bridge pose here. Moving back and forth here. And next time your hips are off the floor, just hold it here. Slowly come down, hands under your knees, roll on your spine, up and down a few times. And come all the way down and over on all fours. And shoulder width apart, spread your fingers. And take your right leg back, tuck your toes, press back. So go back and forth here a few times. And then press back and hold it. And back leg up, flex the foot, engage your core, left arm forward. So opposite arm and leg off the floor. Still breathing. We never hold. Rest your breath in yoga. Or most of the time not. So if you feel like you're holding your breath in a pose, just back out. Left hand to the floor. Tuck the toes on your left foot. And see if you can send your right leg back. Three-legged dog. Maybe your left heel is not on the floor. Don't worry about it. And bend your right knee and open your right hip to the ceiling here. And straighten your right leg again. And come forward. Plank pose. We're going to do two push-ups or chaturanga. So you can do that on the knees if you want. Looking forward, inhale and exhale, elbows next to your rib cage. So you just come as far as the upper arms are parallel to the floor. And then up again. And down, hold it. Up again, and then come all the way down to the floor. Tops of the feet to the floor. Hands under your shoulders, elbows in, tuck your chin. Inhale, come to cobra. Shoulders away from your ears, working your spine. And come down. Tuck your toes, plank to down dog. So be on your toes here in down dog. And then see if you can send your heels towards the floor as much as possible. Just a few times. And then come forward again, knees on the floor. this time. Left leg extends, tuck your toes. Move back and forth a few times. And then hold it, pressing back. And back leg up, flex your foot, right arm forward. Hips are square to the floor, engage your core. Right hand down, tuck your toes on your right foot, and left leg back. Three-legged dog, head is relaxed. And then open that left hip, bending the left knee. Three-legged dog again, come forward to plank. So let's do two push-ups today with the knees on the floor or not, or come down and do a cobra. And then all the way down. And we all come into cobra here. Heart is open. And down, tuck your toes, plank. Down dog, this time bend your knees. Heels off the floor. And then straighten your legs. Bending your knees, straighten your legs. And finally, come to stillness in down dog. Relaxing your head, your jaw, shoulders away from your ears. And forming that inverted V. Up on your toes, bend your knees, look forward, and walk to the front. Fold in half, bend your knees. Slowly roll up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Inhale, reach up. And exhale, hinge at the hips, come down. Fold in half. From here, bend your knees and come on the balls of your feet, look up. Exhale, fold in half again. If you need, you need to bend your knees. One more time. Fold in half. Bend your knees. Take a big step back with your right foot. Coming in to low lunge. Or almost low lunge here. So the right knee is on the floor. Feel that stretch in the front of your right leg. And then hands up on your knee. Or all the way up, low lunge. Hands to the floor. And knees on the floor. Hands on your sacrum, shoulder blades together, hips forward. You can look forward and let your head hang back. Camel pose. And exhale, come to child pose. Inhale forward and down on the floor here. Locust variation, so feet off the floor, cactus arms, arms off the floor too. So working your back muscles. Press yourself back. Child pose. Up on all fours, right leg forward, hands on the floor. Tuck your back toes, step forward, fold in half. Come all the way up. Palms in front of the heart center. Do that again, other side. Inhale up. Exhale, swan dive. Inhale, look up. On your toes. Exhale, straighten your legs. One more time. Straighten your legs. Bend your knees and left foot back. Left knee on the floor. Pause here. And then maybe come up, hands on your knee, or reach your arms up. Low lunge. Hands to the floor. Knees on the floor. And camel pose. And child. Come forward, belly on the floor, cactus arms, legs up, locust variation. Hands on the floor again, come to child. Inhale all fours, and this time left leg forward, tuck your back toes. Step forward, fold in half. Inhale, reach all the way up and palms in front of your heart center. Do that one more time on each leg, moving faster this time. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, fold. Inhale on your tippy toes, look up. Exhale, straighten your legs. Inhale, bend again. Exhale, forward fold. Bend your knees, step your right knee back. Inhale, low lunge. Exhale, hands to the floor. And set up camel. Pause here. Exhale, come forward and child pose. Inhale forward. Exhale, locust. Hands on the floor. Exhale, press child pose. Inhale all four. Right leg forward, tuck your back toes, step forward. Fold in half. Inhale, reach all the way up. Palms in front of your heart center. Next leg, inhale up. Hinge at the hips, fold in half. Inhale, look up, bend your knees. Exhale, fold. Inhale, look up. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees, left foot step back, and the knee on the floor. Low lunge. Hands to the floor, knees to the floor, camel pose. Inhale, hands to the floor. And exhale, child pose. Inhale, come forward on the floor. And exhale, come up. Locust variation. Hands to the floor. Press back to child pose. Inhale, all fours. Left leg forward. Tuck your back toes. Big step forward, fold in half, and come all the way up. Palms in front of your heart center. That felt good. Take your blocks or books, or if you even have any, small, pillows may not work. Depends on if you have a bolster, it could work. So take those and place them about shoulder width apart in front of you, and then feet hip-width apart. Hinge at the hips and come down. So depending on how flexible your hamstrings are, you can stay up here on the tall side, maybe on the lower side, or maybe you don't need them at all. Relax your head here. You should feel this in your hamstring. And see if you can feel it at the belly of the muscles, so not the attachment. If it's really straining where they're attached to the knees and sitting bones, bend your knees a little bit. Just breathe into your hamstrings. And then bend your left knee. Take your right arm to the ceiling. You can stay there, or maybe take your right arm behind you and grab a hold of that left inner thigh. So you're rotating, looking up here. And from here, bend both knees, take your right or your left hand in between your legs, and then the other hand behind you. So you're trying to grab a hold, I'll show that from the back too, on your hands together, and then straighten your legs, bending your bending over, head relaxed. I know that's not always easy. If you have a strap, you can hold that. My strap is very long. So I hold that in one hand, take it in between my legs, and then I can connect. And then try and straighten your legs as much as possible. Again, find your edge of the pose. So don't overdo it, don't over push. See what works for you. Breathing the whole time. Check in with your breath. If it's still smooth, then you're probably okay. You're starting to hold your breath, or if it's choppy, just back out. And slowly let go. Left vertebrae by vertebrae. Slowly, slowly. Inhale and exhale. One more time. Inhale and exhale. One side left. Hinge at the hips again. Come down. This time, bend your right knee. Left arm up. Stay there. Or grab a hold of the inner right thigh. Let go of the inner thigh, bending both knees. This time, right hand in between your legs and the other arm on the outside. See if you can place your hands together, straighten your legs as much as possible, relax your head. So this is a good start to do some of the more advanced poses, like Bird of Paradise. Maybe we'll try that another time. And let's go. Shake it out here. Place my blocks on the side and slowly roll up, vertebrae by vertebrae. One more time. Inhale, reach arms out and up. And exhale, one more time. Let any tension go. Front of your mat, feet together. Coming into chair pose. So sit down in that imaginary chair. Fingers sweeps, then sweep to the floor and reach up. Engage your core muscles here. Weight to the heels. You should be able to see your toes, maybe even wiggle them. Sit down, maybe deeper. Reach your arms up. And fold in half. Uttanasana, head is relaxed.
So again, if you feel too much stretch in the back, bend your knees. And everyone bend your knees. Take a big step back with your right foot, setting up high lunge. The first runner's lunge, back leg is straight, back heel off the floor, and come all the way up. High lunge. 90 degree with the front knee. Take a few breaths here. And then bend your right knee and cactus arms. Maybe a little bit of back bend here if it doesn't hurt. Otherwise, just stay up with your torso. And come up high lunge again. Open to the right side, setting up warrior two. So if you need to widen your stand, do so. Front heel aligned with the back arch. As always, shoulders over your hips. Maybe looking over that left hand. Make sure that bent knees is straight forward, so it's not buckling in or out. And straighten both legs, coming into Trikonasana, triangle, if you want. You can have a block behind that front foot. Inhale and exhale, hips back, arm reach forward. And then if you have a block, maybe you want to use that today, just to do something different. Place your hand on it. Again, some of you may need to have the block on the tall side. Working on stacking your hips here. Or shoulders, I mean, not hips. If your neck hurts, just look down. Otherwise, you can look up. Inhale and exhale, press yourself up and turn the left foot forward, or to the right, I should say. So your legs or feet are parallel, or you can even be pigeon pose here. And maybe you want your blocks in front of you here too. Inhale, exhale, fold. First, actually, I'm gonna put the blocks next to me. Walk your hands forward and press your hips back. So you're kind of in a wide down dog here. Press your feet into the floor. Can you feel this? Where does it feel? If you need to, of course, you can bend your knees. Then walk your hands in. Now maybe the blocks will come handy. You can even place your hands on the blocks here and then relax your head. If you need to do it on the tall side, you can do that too. And if you're really flexible, maybe you want to place your hands in between your feet and relax. Feel this stretch even more in your hamstrings. And come halfway up. Move your blocks to the front. We're going to use them in a minute here. Bend your knees. Reach your arms forward. And slowly come up, turn to the front, pyramid pose. So feet about hip width apart, you're not in a tightrope, hips forward, placing one block on each side. So of course, if you don't have blocks, you don't have to do it. with blocks, you can do the same poses, just using the floor. From here, inhale and exhale, torso parallel to the floor. Once you get here, make sure your hips are still squared. So your right hip forward, left hip back. And then if you have blocks, want to use them, you can place your hands on them and then relax your head. You probably feel a stretch here in the back of your left leg. And slowly press yourself all the way up. Bend the front knee. Torso comes forward. I'm moving my blocks forward too. And then come up here. So you are standing on your left foot, left leg straight, right leg parallel to the floor. Flex your foot. Right foot. You can have your hands on blocks if you want. Bend your knees and step your right foot behind the left so your legs are crossed. Slowly come up here. Uncross your legs. Inhale and exhale. Feet together again. And sit in your chair, breathing here. Sit a little deeper. Two more breaths here. So reach up with your arms. And fold in half. Bending your knees. Big step back. Left leg this time. Runner's lunge. And high lunge. So on the ball of your left foot. Then bend your left knee and cactus arms. And do whatever you did on the other side. Maybe a slight back bend. And straighten the back leg again. Open up to the left side. I'll move so you can see me here. Set up. Warrior two. Always take time to get into the pose. Just check in with yourself. How does your body feel in this pose? Where's your mind in this pose? And take a block on the outside of your right foot here. Straighten both legs. Inhale and exhale. Reach forward and place your hand, your right hand maybe, on a block. Looking up or down. Trikonasana. Check your hamstrings again. Do you feel it on the belly of the muscle? Or the attachments. Maybe you need to bend your knees just slightly. And press yourself up. Turn your right foot in. Have your blocks ready again if you're going to use them. put them on the side. Inhale, exhale, hinge at the hips. Hands to the floor, walk them forward and press your hips back. Wide down dog, relax your head. Calming yourself even more in this forward folds. You're not on the balls of your feet, press back. Maybe bend your knees, walk your hands in. If you want to use the blocks again, you can do that. Or not. Feel even more of a stretch in your hamstrings. Start walking your hands forward, bend your knees, reach your arms forward, and gently come up, turn to the front, pyramid pose, use your blocks if you did it on the other side, make sure your hips are square to the front, inhale and exhale, torso parallel to the floor. Check your hips here, and then use your blocks if you want to. Head is relaxed. So maybe forehead even touches the shin bone on the right leg here. Something to strive for, maybe. Two more breaths here. And slowly bend your front knee. You can move your blocks forward. Come up. And then hands on the blocks if you want to. Your hands are under your shoulders here. Straighten the left leg back, flex the foot, so toes to the floor. Bend your front knee slightly and place your left foot behind the other foot, so you're crossing your legs. And slowly come up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Inhale, exhale, shake your legs maybe. Hands over your heart. Close your eyes. Just a brief pause, checking with your body and your mind. Always observing, no, not judging. Slowly open your eyes. Feet hip width apart. Just move back and forth here on your toes, on your heels. A few times. Just spread your feet, your toes out. And feel the center here. Feet on your floor, grounding yourself. Then on your toes, maybe reach forward your arms, balancing, breathing. Bend your knees and see if you can come all the way down And hands on the floor. Good job. Let's get into some floor work. Extended puppy to start with. Knees hip width apart. Walk your hands forward and chest towards the floor. Maybe forehead is on the floor here. So you have your hips over your knees. Melt your heart towards the floor. Slowly walk your hands in, knees together, sit on your heels, interlace your hands behind your back, shoulder blades together. Just look forward here, or if you prefer, get your head and look up. Opening up your shoulders. Let's go. Gate pose. Come up on your knees. Right leg out to the side. So the toes aligned with the knee there. Reach your left arm up and lean over to the right side. Feeling a good opening here on the left side. And hands forward. Take your left arm over to the right side. Your left shoulder on the floor if you can. Thread the needle variation. And slowly come up. Let's switch legs. Left leg out. Right arm up, lean over to the left side. And come down, walk your hands forward this time, right arm over to the left side. And come up, sit down, starting with Baddha Konasana, soles of the feet together, knees out to the sides, pressing out with the elbows and in with the knees. You can have a straight spine here. And now you can relax your head. And if you have a block, you can even, depending on how flexible you are, you can place your forehead on the block, maybe. Don't worry if you're not there yet, just do what you can. And slowly come up. Extend your left leg. And right foot on the inside of the left thigh, or if you want, you can put the top of the foot on the hip crease here. Half here, what do you call it? I forgot the name right now. And then if you have the belt or anything, you can place that on the ball of your left foot. Flex the left foot. Inhale and exhale. Gently press here. Half lotus, that's what I was going to say. Try and relax your muscles in the left leg here. Find the edge of the pose. And sit up. From here, extend both legs, flesh out of your sitting bones. You can use the belt or strap again under both feet. Inhale and exhale, come forward. And if you don't have a belt, that's fine too. You can just come forward. Some of you may reach your feet. Anything works that works for you. And slowly come up. Let's do other side. So this time, bending the left knee, use a strap if you want, under the other foot, come forward, hold it here. And after a few breaths, you may want to move a little and adjust the pose and see if you can get deeper into the pose. Maybe half lotus. Slowly come up. Second time, both legs extended, flesh out of your sitting bones. Hashimuttanasana. Sitting tall, heart forward. Stay here for a few breaths and then you can lean forward. You can even use a block here and put your forehead on. Just explore. Check in and see where your thoughts are. Are you still here? Or are you thinking about what you're going to do after the class? And gently bring your mind back. You have kind thoughts to yourself, towards yourself. Or are you frustrating that you can't get your forehead to your shins? Don't be, doesn't matter. It's all about how you look at a thing. Think it as working on your patience, taking the time it will to get to where you're supposed to get. Have some fun on the way. And slowly come all the way up. Let's do some core work too. Can't forget that core. So reverse crunches. First, tug yourself in, knees to chest, maybe knees from side to side. Release any tension you have in your back. Then feet off the floor, palms on the floor. So you come in crunch here, extend your legs and reach the toes almost all the way to the floor. So you're hovering here. So crunch and extend. Crunch, extend, and continue. And of course, if you feel any pain in your back, just adjust to do something else. Let's do four more. And feet to the floor. So have your feet in front of your knees so they're not underneath here. from here, you're going to engage your core, navel into spine, come up and see if you can touch your feet from all the way down and up. So use your core muscles here, not the momentum. So you're not using any other muscles. Really concentrate on your core to come up. If you feel starting to burn, that's a good thing. Let's do four more. You can do it to your left. All done. Knees in again, hug yourself a few times. And take your strap. Kind of start or ending the way we started. Belt under the ball of your right foot. You can have your left knee bent if you want to. And then straighten that right leg, flex the foot. And then maybe straighten the left leg too. So flexing both feet here. Let go, same thing other side. Strap under the left foot. Bending your right knee this time. Stay there or straighten your right leg, flex both feet. And let go. Take your hips over to the left side and knees to the other side. Just a supine twist here. And come to the middle. Move your hips to the other side. And knees down again. And middle. Make yourself into a little ball here. Roll up and down on your spine a few times. Shoulders on your back, on the floor, hands on the knees. Draw circles with the knees in one direction and other direction. We are ready for final relaxation. Extend your legs out. If you have a bolster or a pillow or something, you can even take that under your knees. Really relaxing too. If you have an eye pillow, you can place that over your eyes. Close your eyes if it's comfortable. Deep inhale and exhale through the mouth. One more time. So for next exhale, let go of anything that doesn't serve you, thoughts, tension in your body, whatever it is. Inhale. And Just breathe in and out through your nose. Normal breathing. Just be relaxing your muscles. Just honor this precious time. We're in complete stillness. Rejuvenating, recharging your body. Slowly start lengthening, deepening your breath. And bring your awareness back to the here and now, to your physical body. Start moving your toes, your fingers. And if your bolsters are under your knees, move it to the side and come over to the right side. Fetal position, resting on your upper right arm. And when you're ready to come up with your eyes still closed, if it feels good, come to a seated, comfortable position. And take a moment here and thank your body for being able to move. Your heart supporting you 24 hours a day. We don't even pay attention to the breath. Just scan your body, see how you feel, check in with your mind. So I just want to say the practice of rolling to the right side. Sometimes people ask, why don't we roll to the left? Of course you can do that, but it's symbolic and also physiologically based. So in India, it's considered more auspicious to enter a holy place with the right foot. And in many parts of the world, we use the right hand to greet someone. This side, the right side, also represent the east. So rolling towards the east or the rising sun symbolizes asking for blessings, grace, and bliss. Physiologically, since your heart is on the left side, when you roll to the left, it remains open and free of pressure. It also keeps the prana open and calming you as you're sitting up. Palms together in front of your heart center. Thank you so much for being here. And remember, peace, it does not mean to be in a place where there is no noise, trouble, or hard work. It means to be in the midst of those things and still be calm in your heart. Namaste.
Don't forget to share the love by subscribing to my channel and contribute with a comment too.